Called me an outlaw, called me a dreamer. They said I would change as I aged and grew old, that the memory would fade of the things I had lived through, but the flash fire of youth would slowly turn. But I raise up my glass, drink deep of its flame, to those who have gone, who are links in the chain. And I give my soul's promise, I give my...
We're in the Malahide estuary. It's beautiful. We're continuing. We've got about another 3 hours worth of walking to get to our destination. It's great to be out here, even though we're going to get rained on.
That binds us together, that tears down the walls that would keep us apart. And here's to the future, where dreams will be honored, and the fierce flame of freedom that burns in our... Fire is still burning, the future is still calling. Follow the dream till the end of my days. Wishing's for fools, but dreams are for outlaws. Laughter's for lovers, and tears for the brave. I raise up my glass and drink deep of its flame, to those who have gone, who are links in the chain. And I give my...
Yeah, we're now leaving Skerry's, going up to Balbriggan. We just had lunch at a wonderful little restaurant in Balbriggan, and so far it isn't really raining, so we're very happy about that. Last night in Donabate, we had a great meeting with about 15 people that some folks pulled together for us. And so we're getting the word out, we're keeping at it, and we're ready to move
what
on to Balbriggan.
What was Paul's last name, the councillor?
Mullen. Paul Mullen pulled those folks together.
And it
together.
Was terrific. He was terrific. And his dad came, and a bunch of people, and they were totally supportive. And it was... It's just that kind of support that keeps us going. That kind of great Irish support.
All the things I have lived through, but the flash fire of you would slowly turn cold. But I raise up my glass and drink deep of it.
Okay, what's the most common question you get asked at these meetings?
Are you kidding? They took your passports?
Yeah. That's outrageous, they say. Yeah. It takes them a while to wrap their heads around that.
Pledge to outlaws and dreamers, and light at the edge. So here's to the vision that binds us together. Tears down the walls that would keep us apart. And here's to the future where dreams will be honored.
We know very well the kind of imperialistic ventures that the United States engages in, and we've been trying to stop them for years, and we're going to keep on trying to stop them. This walk is a small part of those efforts.
Get Ken and Tarak home. Yeah, Ken and Tarak want to go home. But I don't want to forget about why we did what we did and why we've been here for 8 months. Because I'm furious about it. And I'm furious about what the U.S. military is being allowed to do to my planet and to my daughter's planet. That people will not even be able to grow up in and have a world to live in if it keeps up.
It's been really interesting talking to you and hearing your story. And I think we're fully with you. Really delighted that you're here in Balbriggan. And I think your case, it illustrates a massive injustice. I'm delighted that you've raised some awareness about your case in the media talking to some of Ireland's leading politicians, but it's just an outrage when we compare the actions of others who've taken action in Shannon. They haven't received the same penalty as you. You are effectively interned, imprisoned in Ireland for the last 7-8 months and into the indefinite future. That's not the way the Irish justice system normally works.
The walk might be interrupted next week because you have an impending court date. Is that right?
Actually, it turns out that we can work with that court date. Court date is on the 8th. We'll be ending the walk on the 7th.
Okay, perfect. Great.
Call me an outlaw. Called me a dreamer. They said I would change as I aged and grew old. That the memory would fade of the things I